that the country incurred due to illegal demonstration in various parts of this country is in excess. If we were to call all the retailers who closed their businesses for fear of looting, because there were businesses that were looted and they lost millions. But we are talking of about a countrywide where we lost a lot of money in excess. If we were able to just, it would be more. But my appeal and my request is that the individuals who organized, the individuals who led, which is in this case the leaders of a senior party, should be held responsible to pay for the damages. Because if this continues on a weekly basis, Mr. Speaker, it will bring this country to a standstill. And as such, as responsible leaders, then measures has to be put in place to make sure that nobody wakes up one morning just because they lost an election and say, I'm going to go to demonstration. Because if we did an election and for sure we had a winner, democracy may not be the best system, but it is the best that we have. If you compare it to socialism, tyrannism, and many other systems, democracy is the best. And it says, once we've declared a winner, then the rest of the losers have to accept and we move until the next election. But it has become a pattern that as when someone loses an election, the next thing he does is to call a demonstration so that they can either have a portion of the government. So the only option is to have them pay or compensate the losers or the people who are losing their property, their businesses, and even lives. Because what is the government doing? The IG, Inspector General, has been given responsibility to make sure and enforce that there is peace in the country. So that if there is such demonstration that is illegal and also not peaceful, they should be able to enforce law, arrest those people who exactly are doing the demonstration, who are causing mayhem, because if it was peaceful, we could not have lost life. If it was peaceful, they would not be looting. If it was peaceful, people would not be closing their business. So I urge the CS of Interior, I urge the IG to continue to make sure the rest of the Kenyans will continue to enjoy their rights to live in this country and do business in this country. Mr. Speaker, this week there were some investors who were present in the country. When this chaos started and demonstration started, they decided to get their tickets and go back. And they decided Kenya may not be the best place to invest. And as such, Mr. Speaker, if we continue to lose tourists, if we continue to lose investors, when is this economy going to recover? Why do we allow one individual or a few individuals to continue to cause instability, to continue to cause loss of revenue? And we know the claims that they are saying that we want the servers to be open. The servers are there. You go to the website of IEBC, you'll be able to see. The results that was declared at the polling station are the forms that you'll need. There is nothing like a server to be open. So, Mr. Speaker, I wish to continue to urge the government that is in place to instill and make sure the peace is prevailing in this nation. We cannot agree every week we are closing businesses. Every week we are not able to do anything in Nairobi, in Eldoret, in Kitumu, just because somebody has declared it is a public holiday. So let's go and demonstrate. As such, I am just requesting that we continue to discuss as we discuss this particular motion, but in real fact, we want the Inspector General, the police all over the country. And I want to commend the police. Regardless of all the pressure that they were putting, all the demolition.
You have run out of time. Fair enough. I have order. You can have
for additional.